Hey guys, what's up? This is Steve here. Today we're going to be doing another unboxing of a product that I'm really excited to show you guys. I've waited for this product for a very long time, and this is the Keychron V1. So this is a 75% mechanical keyboard. It is the younger brother or the budget version of the Keychron Q1 and also the Q1 Pro. Now, let me tell you a little bit about this keyboard. So it's a 75% layout. It uses a ABS or a plastic case, which makes it a little bit lighter. It also has dual compatibility with Windows as well as Mac. And importantly, it has the knob, which I think is an amazing feature. And also this one has hot swappable keys and self-facing RGBs. Now, what's particularly striking about this keyboard is that it's only $125 Canadian compared to the Q1, which is $250. Now you might be wondering, what's the difference between the two different types of keyboards? Well, let me tell you, the Q1 comes with gasket mounted tray, so there's a lot of flex when you type, and also it comes with a full aluminum case, which makes it extremely heavy, but also gives it that premium feel. Overall, the sound profile and the typing experience on the Q1 should be better than the V1, but for the price difference, the V1 I think comes pretty close. So we're going to be doing an unboxing, and let me know if this keyboard is something that you might be interested in for your next mechanical keyboard. So the box itself is pretty standard for a keyboard. This particular model is the V1D3, and I think the D3 stands for the Keychron K Pro brown switches that I opted to use. This particular model is also the carbon black, which is not a translucent case. On the box itself, we have here the Keychron logo and the Keychron keyboard. And on the back, we have some of the specs, which I mentioned earlier. So let's get our trusty scissors and open up this box and take a look what's inside. All right, so we first start off with a piece of foam that protects the box and the keyboard. Put it right here. And as usual, as expected, there is a quick start guide for the Keychron keyboard. It tells you which keys that you can switch. So here you can switch between the Mac keys and the window keys, which would be helpful. And we have our keycap remover. This is the first item. A little bag for that as well. Of course, there's also the little brochure that teaches you how to remove the switch and how to be putting it back in so you don't break those switches. And then we have a cable. So this is a wired keyboard, remember that. So there's no wireless function on this. This is a USB-C to a USB. It looks pretty long, it's a braided cable. So that's what it comes with. And then inside the box as well, I'm just gonna put this here so you can see. So it has the keyboard and then additional items here. Oh, look at this. There is a couple of more items. So there is a Phillips screwdriver so you can open the case and mod it. There is a switch remover. There's an Allen key, which I presume is to take the case apart. And also a couple of screws. These are thumb screws. There's two gold ones right here. I'm not really sure what those are for. And then there's four tiny Phillips screws. So I guess if they break, then you could use it to replace some screws. Okay, so 4 screws and 2 thumb screws. That comes in the bag here. And there's one more item. Oh, so these are the Windows keys. You get the Windows key, an Alt key, and the Insert key. Right there. The keyboard itself is right in the center. And let's take it out. So it comes in a little box. I mean, a little plastic case here. Just gonna put this to the side. And I can tell you from lifting this up, this is pretty light. So it's better than your typical keyboard, but it's also much lighter than the Pro Series, which uses a partial aluminum case. And wow, this is actually really nice. So the black itself, the carbon black, is basically matte black. And the keyboard itself has, as you can see, the Windows keys, the option and the control key, and it has a row of function keys. It has the knob, and also the knob can be pressed, and you have a page up, page down, and a home button, and also the arrow keys. So on the back, I believe there are legs or feet. So yes, there are feet right here. So we can either bring it up by this much, so you can have an angle, or if you find that the angle is too high, you can actually close it up and bring up the smaller feet, which gives you a lower angle. I believe the angle is 5 degrees and 3 degrees, but I'll have to check up on that. So that's the keyboard. And also on the front of the keyboard, right here, we have the USB-C input for connecting to your PC, and also a switch that allows you to switch between Windows and Mac operation mode. So remember, there's no wireless in this keyboard, that's okay. I think for the price, you are sacrificing the gasket mount and also the aluminum frame. So last of all in the box, there's actually an instruction manual that I didn't show. And basically this shows you how to take off the keys and switch them. So if you wanted to do that, you can read this. And we're gonna do a quick test here for a sound test. So I can hear a bit of ping actually on my table. But the typing experience is pretty good. This is the knob. There's a little bit of granularized clicking every time you turn it. And there's a nice little press sound. Okay. So definitely compared to the K8 Pro that you might have seen before, the height is actually much lower and might not put as much strain on your wrist. Okay. All right. So that's pretty much the end of the unboxing video. We're gonna do a formal sound test in a bit. And also stay tuned for some perspective views. Let me know if this keyboard is something that you would be interested in. This is a nice keyboard. So here is the thumb screws that I mentioned that they gave extras. And there's probably some screws somewhere for these small black ones. Anyways, all right, take care, stay safe, and I'll see you next time.